Danny and I are taking over the show.
You are?
I'm your boss now, so we're going to have to postpone this fight for a couple of years.
Really?
Yes.
No, I mean, you're really taking over the show.
Yes.
Or we could just end it now. The fight.
That'd be fine, too.
First of all, could you stop telling people we broke up because of the national anthem? It makes me sound like an idiot.
Actually, consensus is it makes me sound like an idiot.
Well, be that as it may, and truer words were never spoke, please stop it.
Fine.
We didn't break up because of the Dodger game.
No, we didn't.
When you were promoting the movie, I was holding your hand every step of the way. When I had a CD to promote in 52 markets in 15 days, you disappeared.
I didn't disappear.
You got cold and you got mean.
Right after you went on the 700 Club. Is that timing lost on you?
This was an album of spiritual music. Those are the people who buy spiritual music.
I don't care if it was an album of the Three Wise Men covering the Doobie Brothers. You put on a dress and you sang for a bigot.
I sang for his audience, not every one of whom is necessarily the grotesque stereotype you'd like them to be. Most of these people have nothing except their faith, and that moves me.
Throw in the Halloween costumes, you got yourself a Klan rally.
I'm sorry.
Fortunately, I'm on about 8,000 milligrams of painkillers right now.
And I'm sorry if my going on Pat Robertson offended you, and if I had to do it again, I wouldn't. But the sketch that got cut, I stood by that sketch all week. And I stood by it all night, and I'll stand by it in front of the press. And you know what that sketch was called? Crazy Christians.
700 Club isn't a comedy show.
There's no way to get this idiotic argument behind us?
No. But score for us on Friday nights, so we won't have a problem. I'm looking forward to working with you. Professionally.
You are an adolescent, oversexed whoremonger with the sensitivity of a head of cabbage.
And all that will begin in just a few minutes.
You've been dating Jeannie?
Harriet.
She saw you do 40 leg lifts at your house, jackass. She was very impressed. She told us all about it. Simon and Tom couldn't look at me. Neither could Danny. I was humiliated. What do you have to say?
Me?
Yeah.
Don't ever walk into that room and talk to me in front of the staff like that again. I will bench you until Christmas. I will make you the highest paid extra in Hollywood, Harry. I will, so help me God, pay you to wave and say goodnight at 1 o'clock in the morning. Do you understand?
Yes.
Now, what is your problem? That after you broke up with me, I went out with somebody else? That's what almost always happens.
Not someone from where I work. There are 17 strip clubs within a 3-block radius of this place for you, not someone from my show.
It's not your show, it's mine, and there are only 5 strip clubs within a 3-block radius. I spent my 20s in this theater.
I've been here 7 years.
And I was here for the 2 before that, so was Jeannie for that matter.
Were you dating her then?
I'm not dating her now.
She just sleeps with you from time to time?
You broke up with me, Harry. And if you don't believe me, I've got a copy of the email. Yeah, she did it by email, ladies and germs. I got a copy of the email on my hard drive and another one in a safe deposit box at City National.
That's funny, because I keep all your things nicely stored on a garbage scow off Catalina.
Right, so can I go date a woman who doesn't?
Well, that population's getting pretty thin. Bad enough I gotta read about you with Nina Suvari, Fiona Apple, Rachel McAdams, Marlo Thomas.
You think I've been dating Marlo Thomas?
Who the hell knows what you do, you addle-minded pervert?
Marlo's married to Phil Donahue, who can still beat the crap out of me anytime he wants.
Thank God.
Seriously, he's a huge Irish man.
I'm too tired for this.
I never dated any of those people.
Page 6 said
it. Oh, then you got me, because if Page 6 said it, then it must be true. Did you get hard confirmation from the Drudge Report?
I got confirmation from Jeannie.
About who?
About Jeannie.
Jeannie and I have been friends for a long time, but you don't have to worry. I don't date or do anything with people who work for me.
Yeah. I feel relieved. In fact, I think I'm falling in love with you all over again.
Harry.
If I slow danced with Danny, your head would explode, and you know it. I have an active imagination, Matthew. I'm paid a lot of money for it. And you had to know I was going to find out. So now I have this in my imagination. That's just mean.
Harry, I didn't mean to be mean. Danny sent her home with me to make sure I was okay.
And?
And I just want to make sure that... I mean, we need you this week. We need a great show, and, you know...
I see.
So, you can keep your head in the game?
Sit down, write, and give me a damn audience. You know, I did Midsummer Night's Dream in the park 2 summers ago.
You think they know in Ely, Missouri, that the play is about a bunch of people who basically take ecstasy and all sleep with each other?
I was Helena.
I was there.
So I... admiring of his qualities, things base and vile, holding no quantity. Love can transpose to form and dignity. What ho, Puck? I knew I'd get you.
You knew you'd get me too.
Matthew, you gotta see that the focus group stuff doesn't get out to the cast anymore.
That shouldn't have happened. Danny talked to Ricky and Ron. I'm sorry about that.
How does it work? Who does it?
Focus groups?
Yeah.
They contract it out. NBS uses a group called Viewer Strategies.
Do they make up the questions?
Yeah, but then anybody can feed them questions they want to answer. Jack, Jordan, sales, promo. Danny and I can ask questions. If I want to know what people think of...
what people think of what?
Excuse me.